This is our take on a classic French country apple cake. Lots of recipes cover this one. They're all just a little bit different, and we've sort of picked and chosen little bits and pieces of different ones that we like, and then in a couple places added our own twist. So, today we're making French apple cake. So for our version of this cake, this is what you'll need. Butter, cinnamon, apples, sugar, salt, cognac or brandy, flour, baking powder, eggs, vanilla, and some raw sugar crystals. So the first step is to brown the butter, and this is not a traditional step for this cake, but we've done a lot of brown butter recipes lately, cakes, waffles, pancake cookies, and we really like that sort of nutty, caramely flavor, and we think that that's gonna play really well with the apples. So we brown the butter in a wide frying pan, swirl it often, keep a really close eye on it, and while that butter is browning, we will prep the apples, so peel and slice them. And you know, you could slice the apple thin, you could slice it thick, you could cut it up into cubes, do whatever you want with the apple, it's your cake. Once the butter is browned, you want to take it out and put it into a bowl and then mix in the cinnamon. Cinnamon is not traditional with this cake, but again, sort of cinnamon, apple, caramely butter, we think it will work really well together, so stir in the cinnamon and then set that aside. Into the frying pan that you browned the butter, throw in the apples and about a tablespoon of sugar, and you want to fry those apples down, you want to drive off a lot of the moisture, and you want to get them a little brown and caramely on the outside. Now, most of the traditional recipes call for dark rum. We kind of thought that brandy or cognac would work really well. So you want to put that in while you're frying the apples, give a stir, drive off all the alcohol, but concentrate those flavors. And the apples are brown caramely, not too caramely, not too brown. Put them onto a baking sheet and let them cool. You can just leave them on the counter, but if you're impatient like I am, you'll stick it in the fridge or the freezer. Just not too long. The rest is pretty much like a standard cake. Whisk together all of your dry ingredients in one bowl. In another bowl, whisk together the eggs, sugar, and vanilla. And then to that mixture, put in the brown butter. Again, whisk it all together, get it really well incorporated. Then you want to stir in the flour mixture and get that together as a nice batter. And then you want to mix in the cooled apples, making sure that they're fully covered in the batter. Put that into your baking tin, smooth at the top, give it a couple of whacks on the counter, and then stick that in a preheated oven. Now, of course, this is the part in the video where I have to admit that we forgot to sprinkle the top with the raw sugar crystals, so we opened up the oven, stuck our arm inside, sprinkled on the sugar crystals. It's one of those things that it looks nice, it tastes great, but if you don't do it, it's not a big deal. Now you're gonna bake this cake for 55 to 60 minutes until it's a deep, rich brown color. Because of a lot of the things that we've changed along the way, this cake is going to be way darker than a traditional French apple cake. Most of those are very light colored. This one is going to be much darker, and that's because we've caramelized the apples, we've added the cinnamon, we've browned the butter, so on and so forth. You wanna make sure that this cake is completely chilled before you serve it. You might not wanna eat the whole thing in one sitting. Thanks for stopping by. Hope to see you again soon.